President Marcos vows to continue building major infrastructure in the country as he led the inauguration of a 25 billion peso road project in Zamboanga, Sibugay. The Improving Growth Corridors in Mindanao Road Sector Project involves the construction and improvement of around 152 kilometers of roads and bridges in the Zamboanga region and in Tawi-Tawi province. Marcos notes the project will not only expand the Brunei, Darussalam, Indonesia, Malaysia, Philippines, East ASEAN Growth Area Road Network, but it will also strengthen the economic and peace and order initiatives in Mindanao.
Ayala Corporation's Electronics Manufacturing Unit, IMI, launches an assembly line for electric big bikes in Laguna. The manufacturing facility is in partnership with U.S. firm Zero Motorcycles. It is located within the Laguna Technopark facility of IMI. The full electric motorcycle assembly, the battery assembly setup, and the first units that were assembled in the country were showcased during the inauguration on Friday. Zero sells a range of e-bikes which have a range of up to 301 kilometers and are capable of producing 110 horsepower and hitting top speeds of up to 200 kilometers per hour. Vietnam also planning to cut rice export, but it says it will continue with its commitment to the Philippines as it seeks to boost trade ties with the country. Let's hear more about that from our correspondent Lady Vicenjo, who now joins us on the line. Hi, Lady. What can you tell us?
Stanley, the embassy of the Socialist Republic of Vietnam expressed its continued support to the Philippines amid possible supply woes on rice due to El Nino. The business matching event of the embassy, Vietnamese ambassador to the Philippines, Wang Goi-chung, said that the Philippines will not be left behind as Vietnam's key destination for rice exports. Wang said that Vietnam shall export rice to the Philippines when in need, just as how Vietnam promised to ensure rice security in the country during the COVID-19 pandemic. The General Department of Vietnam Customs also reported a 4.2% increase in rice exports to the Philippines, while the Bureau of Plant Industry of the Department of Agriculture recognizes the good trading relationship between the two countries. DADPI Director Glenn Panganiban said that the government is finding ways to be self-sufficient as Vietnam has announced its plan to cut rice exports by 44% by 2030. Aside from rice, Vietnam is also looking to expand bilateral trade with the Philippines, particularly for fresh fruit products. Vietnam Minister of Trade Nguyen Phuc Nam expressed their interest in Philippine tropical fruits such as mangoes, durian, and banana. But Nguyen stressed that they will only accept such imports if the Philippines will also grant import permits for fresh fruits from Vietnam. While DADPI noted that the two countries have similar productions of tropical fruits, it is open to request for access for permits, not only for commodities, but also to agricultural technologies to further strengthen our trading ties with Vietnam. Sandy?
All right. Thank you so much for the update, Lady Vicencio. Let's see how the financial markets in the region traded this Friday. Caution ruled today's session among the major indices as investors digest inflation figures from Japan. We're seeing the Nikkei 225 shedding more than 0.5% to lead losses in the region. The Kospi also showing some resilience, even with Seoul's lower producer price index. Some notable share price movements. We're seeing Taipei's TSMC shedding more than 3% as it reported its first profit drop in 4 years. The world's largest chip maker saw a 10% decline in second quarter revenue. It's also pushing back the start of its mass production to Arizona to 2025 amid a shortage of skilled workers and technicians. Let's take a look now at futures in Europe. They are pointing to a mixed open on the last trading day of the week. Futures on the FTSE 100 are flat but on the upside, as Britain reported retail sales rising more than expected in June to 0.7%. On Wall Street, the opening call for all major indices is green, suggesting a second weekly gain for the Dow Jones and S&P 500. NASDAQ futures, however, are more flat as investors brace for Monday's special index rebalance aimed at reducing the dominance of the tech mega caps. A look now at other local corporate stories. Basic Energy Corporation says the Energy Department has approved its wind energy service contract for its Balayan Nearshore Wind Power Project. The offshore area is located 1 kilometer east of the Calatagan Peninsula in Batangas. The company says the new service contract would push its existing wind power portfolio from 350 to 400 megawatts. Meanwhile, 7-Eleven sees a record net income of over 2 billion pesos in 2022. Philippine 7 Corporation's president and CEO, Jose Victor Paterno, notes people are now buying more products despite shopping less frequently. The company aims to open 400 new stores this year, allotting 3.7 billion pesos in its total capex.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. heading to Malaysia for a state visit, a day after his second State of the Nation address. The Foreign Affairs Department says the state visit will be from July 25 to 27. Marcos will be meeting with Malaysia's King as well as its Prime Minister Anwar Ibrahim. The DFA adds the president and his economic team will be advancing Manila and Kuala Lumpur's bilateral trade. Investment pledges also expected during this visit.
This reciprocal visit between the leaders of both countries in 2023 is a testament to the reinvigorated relationship between the Philippines and Malaysia. It is also timely as the Philippines and Malaysia will mark 60th anniversary of the establishment of diplomatic relations between the two countries.
Marcos will also meet with the Filipino community in Malaysia to share government's plans for migrant workers. The Philippine government launches a new program aimed at addressing the shortage of nurses in the country. Joyce Balancho reports.
The Commission on Higher Education, the Department of Health, and the Private Sector Advisory Council signed on Wednesday a joint administrative order for a program that will provide review classes for aspiring nurses. CHED Chairperson Prospero De Vera says the program will be for those who had failed the nursing licensure exam and are currently being employed as nursing aide or medical staff in hospitals.
Mobilize on the part of CHED yung magagaling na mga pamantasa na magbigay ng review classes para doon sa mga employed sa public and private hospitals para maipasa nila yung licensure test.
The hospitals will endorse the names of their staff who are qualified for the program. Private hospitals will shoulder the cost of the review for their staff, but CHED says it can also provide subsidy should the expenses reach a high amount. For those coming from public hospitals, the government will shoulder the financial requirements.
Idisenyo natin na ganun yun, no? Para hindi sila kailangang tumigil magtrabaho, para magabayan sila. So sa susunod na licensure test, hopefully, kung marami ang mag-a-apply dito, ay madadagdagan ng mga nurses.
The Department of Health sees this program as one of the measures to address the shortage of nurses in the country. Health Secretary Ted Herbosa says, while there are 500 licensed nurses in the Philippines, only half of them are servicing our hospitals. The other half are either working abroad or employed in other industries.
I'm talking about the Philippine General Hospital where I came from. Talagang may nurse to patient ratio kaming sinusunod. Usually yung mga 1:5 yan sa ward at 1:2 sa emergency at saka sa ICU. Pero doon nadinig nyo sinabi ko 1:30, 30, isang buong ward hawak ng isang nurse.
10 higher education institutions have signified their intention to join the review program. Included are the University of the Philippines, Manila, University of Santo Tomas, and Our Lady of Fatima University. CHED says the program will begin once the list of endorsements from hospitals and the number of participating schools have been finalized. Joyce Balancho, ABS-CBN News.